has some news hot off the presses. This station has received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work.
You have one unheard message.
Two more lighthouse keepers headed
first unheard message.
Hi, baby. I'm stuck at the gate and they won't let me through. When you get back home, can you look for my ticket? I must have left it behind. Have a good look around and let me know. Love you. See you soon.
End of message. To delete this message, press
anywhere. It looks like they were halfway through dinner when something interrupted them. There were no signs of a struggle and all their belongings were still there, including a journal kept by one of them. The journal states several times that the island was talking to them. The most common theory is that the men have suffered from cabin fever and were perhaps accidentally washed out to sea. Other cases like this have been reported on in the past, but have never been fully resolved. A full investigation has begun into this bizarre case. We'll update you as the story progresses.
Look how clever our little girl is. I'm not sure exactly what's going on here, but she can already draw better than I can. She takes after her daddy. That's a big box. What is it? Wow, nice wrapping skills. Oh my god, a puppy! I can't believe you did this! I love her! I'm gonna call you Sally. Okay. Now it's time for your gift.
Do you, Sarah Angel Adage, take Gary Ryan Powell to be your lawfully wedded husband? To have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part.
I do. Oh my God, baby, it's perfect. Yes. Yes, I will. I love you, Gary. I'm stuck at the gate and you won't let me through.
Just the two of us anymore.
See you soon.
Thank you.
Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times. The victim's name was Sarah Powell. Sarah managed to make a call to 911 before she succumbed to her injuries. The primary suspect of this brutal murder is believed to be her husband, Gary Pout. He was found deceased only mere blocks away, slumped over the steering wheel of his car after a fatal collision with a tree. The murder weapon was found in the car with him, leading investigators to speculate that he crashed his car while fleeing the scene of the crime. The couple had a daughter believed to be 19 years of age, but police have been unsuccessful in tracking her down. If anyone knows the location, please contact Pleasant Falls PD immediately. It is also believed that Sarah is a victim to domestic abuse. If you or someone you know is suffering from domestic abuse...
June 6, 1999. My hands are shaking as I write this. Maggie's gone. Michael's gone. And Gary's gone too. At least the man I love is. It's just me and the monster living inside Gary. And the beatings are getting worse and I'm running out of excuses. I'm so tired. The lady next door came over yesterday. She must have heard...
woman was found murdered in her home,
stabbed over 10 times,
managed to make a call to 911, had been victim to domestic abuse.
Monster living in me does his drink.
Maybe it is my fault.
Yeah, abandoned him so much. Honey, it's been 4 years. I need you and I love you more than I can express. Please, please get some help. They have a clinic and... No, please listen. Don't get angry. No, please. I'm not the one with problems. I just need to numb the pain. It's the only thing I can do to not feel.
spokesperson from the CADV, or Citizens Against Domestic Violence, had mentioned during a press statement that it's easy to turn a blind eye to domestic violence by explaining away the problem. Often in cases like these, the victim is in love with their assailant.
Who the fuck are you? All you do is drink. You're a monster. Can't live like this anymore.
Thank you.
blind eye to domestic violence.
All you do is drink.
I need you, and I love you more than I can express.
I don't understand how this happens.
Sometimes he scares me.
I just need some numb pain.
Suffer from addiction. Sometimes people have psychological problems.
I told you I was sleeping. He was out with Maggie getting ice cream or something. I don't know. I was asleep.
Look, my baby boy just died, and I don't know how. What kind of God would kill an innocent baby? I didn't kill my son. Yes, I had postnatal depression, but I'm telling you, woke to a noise. I had a strange feeling something was wrong. And I ran to his room and I found his crib collapsed. His lifeless body. It blew up on the bed. My baby boy.
An investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy. The father was out with their six-year-old daughter buying groceries. When they returned home, they found the mother of the child holding the infant in her arms. Authorities have taken the mother in for questioning, but she has since been released. A spokesperson for Pleasant Falls PD told us that the death has been ruled accidental. However, the investigation is ongoing. It's believed that faulty nursery...
I guess. I never really thought about it before, but now that I think about it, with what happened to them and all, I can remember some strange things that went on. Like, just last month, I thought I heard what kind of sounded like chanting coming from outside at around 3 in the morning. I looked outside the window, and I saw Gary standing there. He was in his front yard, and naked. He had no clothes on whatsoever.
I can't hear you. Find me on the baby monitor.
I don't have a investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy.
Look, my baby boy just died.
I had a strange feeling something wrong.
What kind of God would kill an innocent baby?
What kind of God would kill an innocent baby? She has since been released. I've spoken to some of the most immediate details.
January 11th, 1986. We just got back from the hospital with the latest addition to our family, little Michael, and he's perfect. Feeling a little strange though, almost depressed. I feel so guilty for feeling this way when it should be a time for celebration. Gary's been great, but he doesn't understand how I'm feeling. I tried to talk to him about it, but he just doesn't get it and tells me to be happy. He's right, but it's not that simple. Isn't it normal that I'm having postnatal depression with my second child when I didn't have it with my first? I'm depressed and happy at the same time. My God, this is confusing. I hope it passes. I know Gary will support me through this. I'm sure it's all going to be fine. The nurse suggested that I keep a journal to help work through my thoughts. So, here we go.
Oh my, you just keep dying. Over and over and over. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. You'll be stunned by a sudden burst of light, but only if they don't see it coming. Through the switch, bright light. She can't stand it.
Little Michael,
I'm still not used to the name, but it's starting to grow on me. He's perfect, and he looks just like you. He's got your eyes.
For the last holiday period, reached a whopping...
March 1985. He really surprised me this weekend. He blindfolded me and whisked me off in the car. When he took the blindfold off, I saw this horrible little rundown cabin in the woods. He'd purchased this place from an estate sale of a deceased hunter or something. He wants to fix it up so we'll have our own little romantic getaway. Maggie's staying with the neighbors for the weekend, so I guess I'll make the most of it. 24th March 1985. He's like a changed man out here. At first I wasn't sure this place is creepy, but last night was simply amazing. Maybe this was a great idea. It just needs a woman's touch.
Did you hear that? Dad's a drunk. He drank and drank. The answer lies below.
March 1985. I don't ever want to come back. Last night there were all kinds of strange noises. I could hear whispering. I think maybe some of the vocals don't want us here. I heard something in the basement and had to investigate. Oh my god, it's the slaughterhouse down there with some really weird shit going on.
I appreciate taxidermy as an art form, but this looked like more than that. Between the cabins and their history and the strange noises, it'd be a cold day in hell before I set foot in here again. This is how those horror movies start.
To see the bride before the wedding. Shit going on.
Just needs a woman's touch.
A cold day.
It's like a changed man out there.
Thank you.
that training paid off, it seems, as she came first in the annual trial.
And you know who you are. Or do you? Some believe this is their life flashing before their eyes. It was really a moment of clarity, a clear meaning, and understanding that every action you take will bring you closer to your judgment. Do you understand the extent of your actions? The tormentor can become the tormented. The giver of gifts can become the receiver. I only got 6 months. I'm lucky. This reality isn't real. It's only a reflection of you.
We'll be back after these messages.
Mom, I'm so sorry for everything that's happened to you. I can't do this anymore. Do you know how many times I hid under my bed listening to Dad hurting you? Falling asleep under the bed to the sound of you crying? I hate you for not taking me away from here years ago. I'm running away with my boyfriend and I won't be coming back. I'd be safer living on the streets than I am here, and that's no way for me to live. I'm old enough now to understand that none of this is normal. Maybe we'll see each other again someday, but I never want to see him again. Get help, Mom. I do love you. Love always, Maggie.
Of April, 1996. I hadn't spoken to him in what seemed like an eternity, so I was shocked when he asked me to come back to the cabin. I assumed he wanted to fix a marriage. Maybe try to move past everything and start over. Last time we were in the cabin, it was so romantic until the freak show started, and I vowed never to go back, but if it'll help our marriage, I'll try anything to end this nightmare. Once we got there, he just started babbling about this being the place of conception and rummaging through that fucked up basement. I don't know if I should be indulging him or getting help. I want him to get help, but I'm scared. How do you react? Still not used to the name, but it's starting to grow on me. do is drink. You're a monster. I saw a twisted husk smiling back at me.
Before their eyes. Every action you take will bring you closer to your judgment.
Gary's gone totally insane. Maggie ran away. She hates me for not standing up to him. She's
but
right.
Now I'm all alone. And I wish my little girl would come home.
And I love him. And I can't just leave him like this.
I can't just leave him like this. His reality is
June 6, 1999. I'm in hell, and he's on his way there. I'm so weak, I can't even look at my own face in the mirror. The last time I did, I saw a twisted husk smiling back at me. I feel like his madness is rubbing off on me. So afraid of him that I slept under the bed.
A search grid has begun over the crash site, but no survivors have been.
So here he stands, at the gate. Does he understand the extent of his crimes against his eternal soul? He can't set things right. It's over. He can ensure eternity is fitting for those he affected. I'm living it out here myself. Well, it's time to end it. Move on to the best part.
That concludes.
do is drink.
Thank you.